This episode of Nappy Boy Radio is brought to you by McDonald's. So let's talk about one of my favorite items, the quarter pounder with cheese from McDonald's. It's the only kind of beef I'm starting today and finishing. Fresh beef at participating U.S. McDonald's. Excludes Alaska, Hawaii, and U.S. territories.
This is Nappy Boy Radio.
Yo, this is the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast, live with your boy, T-Pain.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your boy, T-Pain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am Vanessa Fraction, a.k.a. Action Fraction, the main attraction, your partner's distraction.
You better know. It'll get you. You better watch out. And guys, we have another great show. How the fuck do we keep doing this? This is weird that we keep doing this.
Umbrellas in your drinks.
ladies and gentlemen, give it the fuck up for Jazze Pha.
When I walk through, I got sauce too. Came with that gang, chop a ring, get a up. When I walk through, yeah, she found them who brought you. Twins in the Benz once again, yeah, I brought two. When I walk through, deal for the sneaks, couple freaks.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am yours truly, Jazze Finzel Burgundy, Obama Luther King Jr. Jackson, 5 the 1st. The one and the only, the longest name in the business and the strongest, you dig? Smell that! At the fragrance counter, and CEO of Show Enough, we gotta talk about some shit. We got some shit to talk about.
I got my brother Javon in the building.
Javon is in his name.
Javon the one in the building.
First of all, how are you doing?
Oh man, blessed, brother.
It's important to be
blessed by the best, man. We made it through the pandemic, the panorama, the panorama.
We made it through the Pandora's box.
Made it to the Pandora's.
Don't know how we did that, to be totally honest. What was your process?
Like, it was a journey.
It was?
We just glad it wasn't a gurney.
I like this journey for you.
You like the journey part.
But what were you doing through the whole thing? Like, what was...
Man, really just recalibrating. Repackaging.
You had time.
Repackaging to resell.
Time. You had fucking time. You had time. Yeah. I think we all just had time to redo. Did anything fuck you up? Did anything?
I actually lost my stepmom.
No way.
Yes.
I'm so sorry to hear that, bro.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Jackie Ward, one of the greatest, you know, that I've known. But she's shining down.
Absolutely.
She was one of the ones that was. An independent promoter, and she was the one that in the Southeast region handled Luke Skywalker.
No way.
Back in the day.
No way.
Luke Skywalker. She was the one. She was like, yeah. Yeah.
You.
So she had her hands full. Those were her babies.
You're dealing with royalty.
You know, Trish DJ, Mr. Mix, and all of them.
Good Lord.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all boys is going crazy, y'all boys.
Yeah. Pack jams and all that.
Man, that's, I mean.
Yeah. So, you know, because you're a Florida boy, looked at those guys like, oh my God.
Yeah, those idols in my eyes.
You probably jacked off to them album covers.
I did.
Just a little bit.
Remember the one? Only a little bit. Hey. Remember the one where you can. You can when Luke was in bed with the chicks, and you can flip the cover and it showed all the titties and shit. Multiple orgasms.
It was a jack-a-roffin boy.
Multiple orgasms. That did not.
Imagine this though, Payne. Imagine this. We had Jack the Rapper. You heard about Jack the Rapper, right? And for all of y'all that don't know, Jack the Rapper was a convention that used to happen once a year every summer in Atlanta, Georgia.
Oh, okay. I was never old enough to get
Mr. Jack Gibson, you know what I'm saying, who was a radio host, and he's just a big, you know, celebrity amongst, you know, all celebrities.
Right.
You know what I mean? And he would bring everybody together every year, all the new artists, all the new talents, where I met Puffy, where I met Latifah, Hammer for the first time, Andre Harrell, are some of the greatest, right? They would always have late at night after all. They would have like seminars in the daytime.
Yeah, yeah.
But at nighttime,
what happened?
Luke Skywalker happened. So you would get all the program directors. You know. So you wonder why they got so much airplay.
Because he was getting everybody's head after.
Oh boy. Hey, boy.
Just,
I mean, ain't never seen nothing like it.
I don't think I have.
My life was completely changed. Imagine me being 17, 16 years old. I can't remember.
I think that's legal. Mm.
But you know what I'm saying? And it wasn't.
I don't think that was legal.
It wasn't, but it was happening.
Told on somebody.
All right.
But I was out there, though. I was out there with my pop.
You was having a good time, though.
You know, I was out there with my pop. You know, he was out there with Rick James and all of those guys.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
You got a Rick James story?
It was a lot.
Yeah, oh, my God. Yeah, I would love a Rick James story.
You have a Rick James story?
Well, I think I can't remember where we were. And, and Rick was talking to, you know, security. So we walking past, and, and you know, I just kind of overheard. He's talking like, okay, when these motherfuckers come, you know, when they come,
right?
I want y'all to run me this way because there's a door that don't nobody know about. I want to get up out of here because they said that if he smokes in this place, that they're gonna take him to jail.
Okay.
They're gonna take him to jail. So when he got up there and he does Mary Jane, he does this salute where he got these two big joints and he's making love to these joints and shit. Yeah. with skin tight pants on. I don't want y'all to picture.
The skin tight.
But, it's turning into something else.
Yeah.
It's turning
so
into something else.
So when they played the shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Basically he smoked his weed anyway.
Obviously.
And the police were waiting on the side and they just looking around like wondering where he went. So he shifted it to the last song of the night so that when it was over, everybody's thinking that he's still there, but he's gone. The crazy thing about Rick was he had this little area backstage, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you have this area and it has like a little chair or something like that, and he have like a little a curtain.
Box office.
You can make No, you got a security guard standing in front of the curtain.
Okay.
Then you got
I'm only imagining what's going behind.
He's inside.
Crazy.
So all of his fans come inside. You know, the ones that can get backstage.
That's
you know, they
said.
Pick them out, hand pick them. You know,
mm-hmm,
you
mm-hmm.
live, you do this, you,
yeah.
you what you do.
Let's
okay, so yeah,
so come on. You
could come inside the box, right?
That's what she said.
You know, you get to do. You
yeah,
get,
yeah,
yeah
that's
right.
What she said.
Right.
I'm just throw that around. Yeah. I'm gonna pass that around to everybody.
Yeah,
that's what she said. Goddamn.
All you little birds. Yeah. So you get to come inside the box.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's not getting better.
Yeah.
It's
obviously
no. No.
So yeah. That's a privilege. That is only after marriage.
Yeah.
You know
right.
what we say, kids, don't listen to what we're saying. That's only after marriage.
Yeah. Yeah.
You get to come inside.
So
the box.
So once they in there, they get to do whatever the Rick they you know. If you know, you wanna smoke a joint with him, do a line with him. You know,
multiple lines.
Ladies might want to give him a blowjob.
Everybody go in the box.
Ladies might give him a blowjob or something like that. So I have to find out after the fact, like, what's going on inside the box.
It's Rick James.
From somebody watching me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, so what the hell is going on? So I'm just seeing women walk in one side and come out the other side.
Right.
So if you was live, you go this way. But if you're not live, you go back into the audience.
Yeah, categories of business.
For the after party.
So you
swipe
left and
can't
right.
Sort you know, out
the girl.
Yeah.
I might want to see you later. You go to the left.
Yeah.
Yeah. What a life.
Yes, Lord.
Holy shit.
I'm having a hard time digesting this.
Y'all made me
That's
snort.
What she said.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, Jesus Christ. You know what?
I'm so sorry.
You know what? We're going to be right back. I hope y'all
Yeah, shut this down.
Shut it down.
The Nappy Boy Radio Podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp Online Therapy. Welcome to the start of your new day. What do you mean, T-Pain? As we begin to see the light at the end of the COVID tunnel, there are still a lot of people feeling down, and maybe you're one of them. I'm here to tell you that today is the day when you get some help. Welcome to the start of your new day. Whether you're feeling anxious or you're struggling in your career or having trouble sleeping, BetterHelp Online Therapy can help. You may not feel depressed or at a loss or anything like that, but if you're feeling a little off, it could be a sign that you should talk to someone. BetterHelp is online therapy, and they have a team of licensed professionals that will assess your needs and match you with a therapist that you can start talking to in as less than 48 hours. They're dedicated to helping you find your perfect therapist match, and if the first person isn't right for you, it's easy and it's free to change your counselors until you find someone that you're comfortable with. You can schedule a weekly video call phone call, or even live chat session to match your schedule. And the best part is that it's more affordable than traditional offline counseling. They even have financial aid available. Here's how you get started. Visit BetterHelp.com/T-Pain and fill out a questionnaire. Then they match you with a professional, licensed therapist. Yeah, it's that easy. That's exactly how it happens. If you need help and you need someone to talk to, why not give BetterHelp a try? Right now, our listeners get 10% off their first month of online therapy at BetterHelp.com/T-Pain. That is BetterHelp.com/T-Pain. Holla.
She come with the shit.
Oh,
what you got, girl?
You just said fizzle.
Now, see, I need to record this.
Oh, my God. Hold on, man. Let me. Hold on, girl.
The other day.
You cannot not, you know what I mean? This is what Instagram is all about right here.
And the name of the drink is the Jazze Fizzle.
Oh, you're going to make me cry.
Oh, no. This is for you, baby.
She going to make me shed a mother tear. This woman, this. Oh my God!
Yeah.
Oh my God!
Absolutely.
Look at Mr. Wisconsin over here.
You know what we're doing. You know what we're doing. We take care of our friends.
What do you got over here? Pull it. Bring it close. Bring it over here.
Bring it close, man.
You guys gotta see the. Tell me what you got over here. What do you got there?
This is their Jazze Fizzle.
The Jazze Fizzle. 1 ounce of mango Ciroc, 1 ounce of pineapple Ciroc, 4 ounces of mango nectar. Shake well and top it off with blood orange soda. Garnish with a slice of blood orange and an umbrella. And there you have. The Jazze Fizzle.
So yeah, we got you right, man. We got you right. We made you your own drink. We got the recipe. We're going to make sure you go home with the recipe. We're going to make sure you got everything you need to make this drink again, because ain't nobody ever made this drink. This is a one-of-one drink, and it's just for you, and it's called the Jazze Fizzle.
Oh, boy.
Oh, this was extra strong just for you.
That was extra strong.
Oh, my God.
Make sure you grab the right one.
Unveil it all.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, my God. Yeah, put it on over there.
Feel free to take a break. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Y'all get to chill with Jazze Pha like a lot. What's the most exciting shit though? Like, what's the like? What really gets you going? Like, right, like when you're in the studio and you actually really like something you're doing. Like, what's that? What's that thing? Because sometimes work turns into not work.
This right here. This, I mean, this is, like just no, really. This. Right here, no, like not working is the work I love. Like
that's absolutely
just like at the end of it, yeah. It should be like, damn. Like when did we do that?
Yeah, like, what the fuck? We did that.
Okay,
play it again.
I know we did it, but like,
right,
we did all that.
Yeah,
like
that's.
Those are the pleasure. The most pleasurable times, like working with CeeLo.
Mm-hmm.
With yourself, even when we were like last time we worked, I mean, we did a little bit, but you know, just those times that you just kicking it and just
it's
having fun.
It's not really work. It's not really work.
Yeah,
at the same
time,
but
don't put too much on it.
Yeah, it's not really work, but it's getting work done.
And I don't like having nobody around trying to be the boss, trying to say when to start vibing.
Right?
How you gonna tell a nigga when to vibe?
You can't tell me when to vibe, you weirdo.
It might just be a whole conversation today. And what they don't know is, if you're not a creative, you don't understand that the information is everything.
Absolutely.
So even if you're just watching TV, watching Scarface, mm-hmm. watching whatever it is that we just love to watch, those things, Minutes to Society, the shit that niggas just love.
Yeah, I tell my people all the time, y'all book me studio, just know that the first 4 hours is going to be me fucking around.
Right.
I'm just not going to do anything. I might listen to shit from fucking 15 years ago. I might just be chilling. I listen to some Prince songs and just chill, just do nothing. Definitely bring me some candles.
I love candles too.
Give me a VR candles headset, and I'm in that bitch for a minute. But
right.
But you don't think I'm just gonna walk in the studio and just start making smashes. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like you can't.
Hey, bitch, it take a minute to make me want to put you in the log cabin.
This shit got a brew, bitch.
I don't just want to put you in the goddamn log cabin.
Can't just have that. You gotta work out finances.
I
want
to put you in a motel.
Take a little time. A log cabin
takes a lot of work.
So y'all got to process what you say. Mm-hmm. Trust the process.
Yeah, that's definitely a process.
It's always a process.
With creatives. That's why I say when I'm, even as a comedian, you know, like sometimes I'm just laying around getting drunk. You know what I'm saying? But that's my process. That's how I get to the funny.
You don't have to get nothing done today.
Not today.
The funny is going to come tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
it's time for the button. Here we go. Take it down. Jazze Finzel.
What happened to that boy?
Run me through the whole name thing. Run me through the whole name thing one time.
Ladies and gentlemen, yours truly, Jazze Finzel Burgundy, Obama Luther King Jr., Jackson 5.
The first.
First.
That's the best part of that whole thing. Jackson 5.
Yeah.
The first. Okay.
All the Jacksons. Tito too.
So, Jazze. A man walks into your residence. Mm. Unannounced. You didn't know what was coming. I don't think you knew what was coming. Mm-mm. This is just a guy.
Comes in.
Guy walks into your residence. He places a button. Just a box. Just
first
a box.
Of all, you don't acknowledge the fact that I got my pistol in my hand?
That's fine, but it's very fucking intriguing.
All right.
So you let him continue.
Oh, shit.
You let him in there.
It's definitely a movie.
It's very intriguing. So what happens is he walks in, goes into your dining area. Chills at the table.
Oh,
he
God.
He down a box. Opens
a stranger.
The box. There's a bunch of strangers.
Stranger.
But you let him in.
Living La Vida Loca. You didn't have to let him in.
He got past the gate, the security, everybody.
Yeah. He was going to come in regardless. Okay. It's inevitable. He's coming.
Okay.
It's that kind of day.
Something. There's some government shit, obviously. Black suit. It's just a lot. It's just a lot happening.
Right.
You don't need clearance. So,
right.
The guy comes in, sits at the table, sits down a box, opens the box.
Is it Will Smith?
If that what makes you the most comfortable, yeah.
Sure.
So
sure.
He has taken
no answers for that.
He has taken the form of Will Smith.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. All right. So sure.
He sits down at the table, sits a box down on the table, opens the box, there's a button in the box, and he says, when you hit this button, you can have anything you want in the world.
Anything.
Bam. You hit the button, you get it immediately. But somebody's gonna die.
Oh.
Ooh.
Let's go.
Yeah. Anybody in the world. Keep in mind, it could be anybody. Now, the list I like to go down is could be a super old person that was really close to dying. Could be a 25-year-old. Ooh. You're going to make them have a heart attack.
Somebody that deserved to die.
Not necessarily. It could be a saint. You also know who it could be? Could be a baby. You could kill a baby. Yeah,
no.
You don't know. Also, it could be second Hitler. You never know. You don't know who you're killing. But somebody in the world is going to die.
Just because.
Because you want this one thing.
Somebody.
What is that one thing that's valuable enough to say, them babies?
The baby.
What?
Ooh.
It could be a baby that died.
Just one baby.
Because you don't know who's going to die.
Just one baby. Just what? Yeah, it's not,
yeah, not the
babies.
Babies.
It's not
the only thing singular. Worth that is to save all the babies. All the rest of the babies.
So one baby got to die to save all the rest of the babies.
That's not
I don't know.
That's against the rules.
It's so got to be. And how would you word that?
It's got to be a tangible material thing. You got to be able to like.
A material thing?
A thing.
There's nothing material.
Tangible. This got to be a tangible.
Word it.
Nothing.
It's got to be something you can put your hand on.
I wouldn't do it.
Okay.
You got to have to.
I can't do it. Yeah. I kind of have to, but it gives me a way
out. Or you die. What you want to do?
Oh, no. I ain't dying.
Or you die. Well,
I got
that
some
thing.
Shit to do. I got shit to do.
Pick that thing.
I got an appointment with T-Pain today.
Pick that thing.
Welcome back to the new rules.
We're making the rules tonight. Right now.
Yeah.
We're making the rules right now.
That was a brand new one. I didn't think about
Shut
that
Shut it down.
You got to do
down.
It. You got to do it or you die.
Okay.
Shut it down.
We'll be right back with the button game. We'll be right back, baby. This episode of Nappy Boy Radio is brought to you by McDonald's. So let's talk about my favorite items at McDonald's, the Quarter Pounder with cheese. A few weeks ago, after a long day in the studio, we had just wrapped up a super incredible project, and everybody started going around the room talking about what they wanted to eat, and I knew instantly. There's only one thing that's going to satisfy my taste buds right now, and that's a Quarter Pounder with cheese from McDonald's. I'm talking about a quarter pound of 100% fresh beef that's hot, delicious, juicy, and cooked to order on a sesame seed bun. You already know what it is, man. That's my jam. Two slices of American cheese, ketchup, pickles, onions, and mustard. Oh, I'm just thinking about it right now. And when I'm feeling really adventurous, I have them add on a little bit of mayo. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you gotta zhuzh it up sometimes, you know? That's just the way I like it. If I had to describe the quarter pounder with cheese in one word, I'd say mouth-watering, delicious burst of flavor. Okay, that's more than one word. Don't worry about that. So go order your own quarter pounder with cheese today. And come on, make it a little extra, you know what I'm saying? With some fries, a couple of McNuggets too, you know what I'm saying? Chilling in there, you know, get your zhuzh on. A quarter pounder with cheese from McDonald's. It's the only kind of beef I'm starting today and finishing. Fresh beef at participating U.S. McDonald's excludes Alaska, Hawaii, and U.S. territories.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. We're still on the button question.
Jesus. Why you had to come back to that shit? See, I thought you were going to change your mind.
Oh, you thought we was going to kill you.
Right. He's like, I don't like this.
This is like a major part
say
of
the question.
Podcast.
Say the question one more time.
A man comes into your house and he says, you hit this button, you can get anything you want right now, but somebody in the world got to die right when
something
you hit
that I want?
Something
anything
that you want.
You want.
But exactly. I got to hit it.
Tangible. You got, at this point.
Something tangible.
At this point, because you didn't want to do
you
it
can't,
on your
you
own.
Can't do like, it's not like a, oh, I want world peace. You can't do that. It's not. You just can't do that. It's got to be something tangible, like a motorcycle or something.
Tangible. Why you minimize it to a motorcycle? Come on, man.
I couldn't think of another word.
Tangible.
Yeah, don't kill it. Don't kill a baby for me.
Okay.
Yeah, you. Oh.
Come on now. You look like you thought about it.
I feel like you thought about it.
Okay. You got your answer.
Okay. Mm. It's a fucked up question.
It's a real question.
It's not. This is not
it's
an
not
easy.
Pleasant.
This is not supposed to be something you can come up with. In
okay. Well, let's get us a children's hospital.
Okay.
A children's hospital.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That works.
That works.
Yeah.
It's helpful.
That works.
It makes you feel. Yeah. That was a great one.
Yeah.
Somebody answer the question. You're the first person actually to answer the question.
Okay. Fully functioning, well going,
Because we can save a lot of kids.
We could.
You know what I'm saying?
And if one person had to die for it,
and you don't hopefully, know,
and
hopefully
you don't
that
know
was
if
a
it's
criminal.
A kid. That's
you
not.
Don't know.
Hopefully.
Let it be.
Prayerfully, it didn't.
That was amazing.
That was pretty good.
That was really good.
That was pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Did I f*** up the question or something?
Mm-mm.
That was the first time
he broke the code.
That was somebody that actually answered the question.
It was pretty good.
A good answer.
I mean,
it touched me.
I feel like I f***ed up.
No,
you didn't.
It wasn't you.
And
you put that on yourself.
And you know what? You got to make the game.
Put that on yourself.
You got the game. Listen. When the answers come out, the game is you can't say the same answer twice.
No. So when somebody else come, don't come with that children's hospital shit.
No.
Yeah.
It's over.
Damn. Like it wasn't no good.
Fuck them.
Don't come with that children's hospital bullshit.
It's been done already.
I like that.
I've never been. Up from the
that's
the
pretty good,
before.
Though.
I mean,
good.
I think I'm such
really
a I'm such a lover of life.
Yeah.
You can
I mean?
Tell
great
by that answer,
person, bro. You are like you're like a really great person, bro. Like,
thank you, bro.
Your love resonates through the entire industry, just from you, and it shows people how you can be what's the word? Ultra rich and still cool as shit,
bro. Listen, the first time I met you, right? We were in Patchworks.
Yes.
You remember that?
You know what? Polo put me with you after I had just made a beat called Jazzy Beat.
Whoa.
And it was because...
Maybe
it,
I didn't know that.
It was because I made a beat called Jazzy Beat on my laptop.
Did you make it for me?
I didn't make it for
us?
How do you feel about that?
I didn't
that?
Make it...
I mean, I want to hear it.
I didn't make it for anybody. It just had a gang of guitars in it.
That's my shit. I'm so glad that people think of when they think of me, they think of guitars.
It was just very soulful guitars. It's all, you know, and I was just like, this is something Jazze Pha would have made. And I made that. And he was like, oh, you fuck with Jazze Pha? And I was like,
yeah.
You want to play this again?
T-Pain is not a liar. Because me, I would have lied. So we come in. I think, was Cash Money in the building?
Mm-mm.
Baby wasn't there?
You said you lied, so just say they were.
No. Because I'm trying to.
Tupac, Biggie, everybody was there.
Shit.
Everybody was
Michael Jackson?
Bitch.
So, yeah, Polo the Don was like, man, this motherfucker. Man, he.
Polo the Don, cuzzo.
I like the voice you have right here.
Hey, dog, I'm telling you, dog. Hey, he was like, I'm telling you, dog. Hey, man, that boy Polo swore by you. It means more.
Right.
Before
it happens. At the beginning.
And I gotta give him his flowers on that.
He was
like, he was like T-Pain. I looked at him like, this nigga.
I was.
I did. I wanted to hear it.
I was mega
ugly.
Got it. I don't know what the hell we did.
Yes, he does.
No, I was definitely.
You had some goals in your mind. You had all goals.
It was a lot. Yeah, I was super ugly, and everybody was like, "No way, this nigga makes good music." It wasn't ugly. I was just broke.
Hey, dog. Let me tell you something.
It'd be a lot of cats.
It smelled. Hey, you know what? We were all working that day. So we were like, Leslie was like pressing me for my opinions on some mixes or something, and I didn't get a chance to hear it.
Leslie.
And I heard something, and I was like, what in the hell is that? I said, that nigga sound like the new Roger Troutman. Like of today. And
this forged me.
Like the Roger Troutman was the first person, right? I was outside. I was supposed to do my first deal at 17 years old with Benny Medina at Warner Brothers. I'm at Warner Brothers, and in front of Warner Brothers building,
right?
Roger Troutman is outside in his tour bus.
Okay.
So he takes me on his tour bus. In the back of his tour bus, he got a big ass 24 track recorder. You know, real to real. So you know that motherfucker hot as hell.
Right.
So you know, he got the windows up. Well, we're in California. And this dude is actually like doing a song.
Busting a joint out.
He was doing some ad libs over one of his songs, and he starts up the 24 track, and he's just like literally on his voice box doing a song. He said, "I mean, this is like one of my new voice boxes.
That's
I want to try."
Not normal,
bro.
It's not just something you just see.
Like, yeah, he brought me back there, and I remember everybody trying to bring me back into the meeting. I'm like, you just brought me on the bus with Roger Troutman. He just dropped.
I don't want to do nothing for the rest of the day.
Do you know what I'm about to say? Do you know like what the song it was?
I can't remember, but he already had out. Heard it through the grapevine and all of those records. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
But Computer Love Out, which y'all was
Computer
doing
Love was already boom. Out. Computer it was already a hit, already a smash. And I'm like,
remember that when you used to do the boom,
bam,
boom, boom, boom. Remember that,
right?
Remember that? I can't do it right.
Everybody in school just beating up their titties.
Yeah, it hurt just then, but I ain't wanna show y'all.
Yeah, that's not something you just get to do, dude.
Bro, like to be right there.
Right.
That's dope.
You know,
I would've crazy.
I would've shit out of my dick.
You remember right slow? Oh my God. What'd you say you would've did? I was about to say something.
I was hoping not to.
I was about to say something, and then
and your mother. Man.
Oh, I said, what'd you say, sir?
You terrible.
Fuck
what
it.
Is this? What is
that's
this?
His armrest.
What do you do with that?
Come on, Ultra Rich. You ain't got that?
No, I don't.
That's $27.99, Ultra Rich. You
I'm
ain't got
one
that?
Of them.
I'm joking.
That motherfucker got too much
money. It might be $27.99. It's definitely not exactly.
But that is slick, though. But it's slick, though.
It, you know?
That's slick.
That shit is crazy. I keep looking at it like, what the
he thought it was a robot. He thought it was going to jack him off. He thought it was going to come over there and jack him off. He said, could you let me use it? He said, sir.
How many times you watched this?
He thought it was a robot.
He said, do it, jack you off.
No, Jazzy.
How many times you watch this a week?
Shut it down.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Jazzy Fay has been the guest of all guests.
He's been awesome.
He has been awesome.
Oh boy,
I really appreciate y'all coming through, man. It's been a thing. You know,
I've been listening to your album. I was listening to your album, dog.
Oh man,
let me tell you something, brother.
Let me tell you something, brother.
Brother. No cap. I just want you to relish. I don't know if I want it.
The green stuff. You can't be serious around me. It's not normal.
And leave it hanging. I want you to relish.
I don't even know why.
Like, all right. I'm feeling that.
When I say relish, I don't even have shit after that.
You can't be serious around me.
I am not. I'm done. No, listen, bro.
Go ahead.
Listen, bro.
Mm-hmm.
That shit, you like, I want you to always realize the superhero that you are to this music shit. Not just R&B. Just the music shit. Shut up. Little Richard. Thank you, baby.
He says, shut up.
Look, no, for real. Okay. I don't ever want you to let a comment, naysayer, or whatever sayer, always stay on track with who you are, with what you are, which is a super mother hero. Mm-hmm. You are legendary, iconic, needed. Needed. Wanted. Missed.
Come on now. Come on.
Heartfelt. The heartfelt. That shit. Those chords that you choose. Those things make people happy.
You should.
Who don't need happiness?
You shouldn't be
right
these
now.
These niggas are miserable out here.
You should not be this.
We need you. No, this from God, bro. I ain't practiced this.
Piano, now, bam, bam. Mm-hmm. Okay, here we go.
You know what I'm saying? We need you, bro.
Thank you, bro.
We need you there.
Absolutely.
And when you feel like you're absent, just give me a call, and I'm going to pull up.
You shouldn't be this.
Totally good. Flowered up. Floral, smelling floral, looking floral. You know what I'm saying? With straight happiness. I might
Miami.
Have a, yeah. And I might have a whole goddamn cage full of doves and just release them just on your behalf.
Inside the house.
Like a
let them fly and hit each other.
Inside the house.
Yeah, bring dove people to come get the mother.
Because there's a job called dove person.
Dove people out here. Dove man, folk
just,
out here.
Nah, man, I just love you, dog. And to hear that music, man.
Absolutely.
Made me teary-eyed and giddy.
Thank you so much,
and silly on the inside. And I want you to stay there.
That's fire.
And go upward. Anything stupid, dumb, crazy, whatever you be thinking, say that shit.
Absolutely. Let's
say that shit.
I'll just be ready, man.
And you know what? Well, my thing is, when I go in the booth, I don't know what your thought process is, and I would like to know. Mm-hmm. But when I go in that motherfucker, I'm like, nigga, I'm finna be 14. Right now.
That's your joint?
That's it.
You just go crazy.
14. Don't give a fuck. I don't care what I say. Fuck y'all. Goddamn. It is.
I don't know what my process is. I'm just alone a lot. So I'm always like, you know, when I record, I'm just like by myself. So I'm like, shit, I like it. So.
Right.
sounded cool as fuck to me.
Hey, obviously people love it.
And I'm, bro, when I record in here and I say a line, I'll say a line and I'm like, wow! Oh, yeah, no. Okay. I forgot nobody else is in here. So, no, I totally understand it. You know, it's that freedom and that vulnerability that you get when you just say what the fuck you want to say.
Right.
And it really helps. Mm-hmm. And I can appreciate you saying that, man. Everything, obviously. Without you, it wouldn't be no me. So,
don't throw it back,
bro.
There's
no.
You weren't supposed to do that,
nigga.
You weren't supposed to give it back. Like
you,
that.
Bro. There's no way. There's no fucking way. When I tell you, bro.
Shit.
When I this was organically said. When you said the first day we met, I had just made a beat called Jazzy Beat. Jazzy Pha is a staple for everybody, especially. Producers that also want to be famous. Because
facts.
You were the producer. It was you. I think at the prime, it was you and Manny.
Manny.
You and Manny.
And we were together.
Y'all were the two niggas that were making the best beats and had the best personalities. Y'all had more personalities than the niggas y'all was making beats for.
Ooh.
It was the craziest time, and I swear that lasted, bro, in my mind today.
Damn.
In my mind today. You Damn. Got to be a good nigga, but you also got to be really good at what you do.
Oh.
So that's a huge part of it. And on that note, Jazzy Pha, if you can think of it, just off the top of your head, what is the T-Pain's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast Song of the Week?
I believe it should be I Like That, featuring Kalani.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast Song of the Week is I Like That, T-Pain and Kalani.
DJ Monte!
Produced by DJ
he
Monte.
He went crazy.
He went
crazy. I love you, boy.
The Nappy Boy Radio Song of the Week.
See, always ride with the top down, even when it's cold.
She got the keys to the boutique. She don't do 9 to 5. 100,000 viewers on her IG live. She do it. Make a toast to it. You ain't never heard of that. And then Birkin bag, stupid. You ain't never heard her brag or say that she going through it. I just wanna tap it, boop, boop it one time. The table. Ooh, you know that your bank account big. Come back on the weekend, you ain't able. Ooh, she gon' be like, I got it. Pull $1,000 out of side pocket. Ooh, that liberty drink you tried to buy. Stop it. Bottles on me, the cork look like a skyrocket. Poppin'. Ooh, she don't want to drink, she want to rent pay. Ooh, she don't pay for nothing, she just get paid.
Stage, I got in my name, all that. And I ain't throwing 20s or 10s. I'm out here paying rent, all that. And I thought I could get the dumb, but I'ma get the ace. Just to run it up and see everybody face. When they bring the checks, oh, I can sign my name. I might have to face all that. Now tell the valet, bring my phone to the front, yeah, yeah. I'm getting it solo, I got it solo. Let the cameras hit my diamond cause, yeah, yeah. I got them rocks solo, I got it solo. It's real boss style fly shit. I ain't the passenger, I'm the pilot. You could hop in, but you ain't driving. All I need is somebody to ride with. Cause I'm a go-getter. Say I'm a go. Type of girl that got you, cause I want you. Not cause I need you. No, I don't need you.
Boop, boop. She don't want to drink, she want to rent pay. She don't pay for nothing, she just get paid.
If you had to pick your top five artists of all times, who would it be?
Oof.
Artist of all time?
Yes.
Dylon. Dylon.
top five artists of all time. And I'm just going to... I'm gonna run my five. I'm not gonna go in any particular order.
Shit!
I'm just gonna run my top five. Devin the Dude, obviously Andre 3000.
Okay.
CeeLo.
Okay.
David Banner.
Oh, Banner?
Busta like Rhymes.
Who? What was the last one?
Busta Rhymes.
Wow.
Ooh.
That's
I can see that though.
That's mm-hmm. all I got for you.
Because he's the antics.
Have
you ever worked with Busta?
Yeah, a few times.
I'm talking about like, have you watched him like?
Yes.
Doing
yes.
shit.
Oh, we've been on tour before.
Damn.
In Australia. We did an Australian tour.
That nigga in the studio is ultra. I was with Dr. Dre.
Uh-huh.
He worked backwards.
He does his ad-libs first.
Yes.
Yeah.
See?
That's what I learned that from.
You know.
That's where I learned that from.
So he had a beat plan, and he was like.
Yeah, even though.
And he had the microphone inside in the control room.
Yeah.
And he was like, yo, top. You must. Your style. Stop.
Come on.
I'm like, right.
No, it's a lot. That's where I learned that from him. I did, on All I Do Is Win, I did ad libs first.
Wow.
I didn't know where I was going with that record. And as I was doing, Khaled was like.
So what did you do? What was the ad lib?
I did, what? Nuff.
This mother, how in the hell?
I didn't know where the fuck I was going.
Everybody
with that shit, man. Bro,
and how in Khaled, the hell?
But Khaled heard me doing that, and he was like, I don't like this. I was like, dude, get out of here for a second. I was like, dude, just get out of here for a second. Trust me. Trust the process. I feel like I'm going the right way. And when he came back in, he was like, it's the biggest record of all time. And it still is. It still is.
That is his biggest record ever.
And I had no idea.
It ends the night.
I was literally
trying. It ends the night. It's the confetti song.
I tried to impress.
Nigga, that is the confetti song.
It is the confetti song.
That shit read it.
You can really call that the confetti song.
You don't pop the confetti.
Right. Until that song comes.
So that would be your best feature you like?
Jeez.
We know it's your biggest.
My best feature?
Because you got a bunch of them.
Damn.
Best feature. That's the biggest, I think. What's the best?
Kiss Kiss is my best. Yo,
really?
Yeah.
That was a jam.
I like that.
Kiss Kiss is my best because I wasn't supposed to be on the song. Because I wrote and produced.
Wait, is that the video you was pop locking on?
Yeah.
I love it. That's when I first found out.
Yeah.
I was like, this nigga right here cold.
Nigga be moving.
I didn't know that. I was like, wait a minute, this nigga's actually cold.
Because I knew
he was cold, but then I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I was calling niggas. I was like, hey man, this nigga pop locking.
This nigga moving.
And slide this shit.
He moving. This nigga's actually moving. He just moved his feet. I saw it slide. It was crazy.
No special effects or nothing.
Nah, but I wrote and produced the song, and I wasn't supposed to be on that. The verse that's on there was like a placeholder.
Wow.
It was just like, also a rapper should go here. And it was like, just lay down something. And I was like,
you murked that.
And then it was like, you know what?
But you know what's crazy?
Just gonna keep that up.
I bet that shit.
Like, you reinvented the remix, though.
Oh, my God.
Remixes, no cap.
You like wear my shit.
Yeah, that's like, you know, I think you should do an EP where you do everything as if.
It's
a remix.
Just all T-mixes?
Yeah. All T-mixes.
Because to be honest, the three top people I like that remix the best is you, Busta, and Luda.
Excuse me. And Luda. Are we talking about rappers?
Of all times, I got to put Teddy Riley in there.
Remixers, period.
I like Teddy.
I would say
remixers.
My
I have a remixer.
Who's your
every
top remixer?
Busta Kick, every
one
time
of the baddest remixers.
Luda be snapping.
Oh, yeah.
Luda be snapping.
R. Kelly's a top remixer for you?
I enjoy his remixes.
Yes.
I don't care what y'all say. His remixes be everything. Like, he did that Bump and Grind remix.
Yeah.
Man, please. It was totally different. I mean, he's in my top
three.
I lost my virginity today.
I mean, you'd say what it is.
Remix. Just going on the
remixes. Just remixes
between you, because Busta and then Luda be snapping, man.
I agree with you. Luda really does good, but I didn't know we were just talking about rap.
No, we talking about just all time. I feel like all time.
I think y'all shunning because of his history.
No, I think R. Kelly's one of the best.
I'll separate the man from the music.
Please separate.
No one can be R. Kelly in a versus.
Not one single.
Okay, I'm not. I don't have anything to say about that.
You gotta put that nigga up against
nothing to say. Yeah,
you do. You better.
Jackson 5.
Hey, Jodeci, nobody.
Yeah, now you got to put
nobody.
You have to put it against Jodeci.
You got to put R. Kelly. You got to put R. Kelly up against a group of dead.
They got no. Yeah.
They got to be dead. You got to put R. Kelly.
The Beatles, nigga.
Nah, yeah, for real. You got to put R. Kelly up against like ghosts and shit.
You got to be like Michael Jackson, Prince, or somebody, because he's ridiculous.
Absolutely. Nah, R. Kelly. I agree with that.
Regular, you can forget it.
He said regular Mike.
You forget it. R. Kelly is a man.
You say regular Mike.
Thank you.
What did you say?
There's a different mic next to you. You gotta put him up.
But he ain't got the mic. But he ain't got the coldest remixes though.
Okay, I'm not gonna argue it down. I'm not gonna argue it down. I just wanted him in the
room. Are we talking features or are we talking remixes?
And I said features on a remix.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Features on a remix. Because when I'm talking remixes, I'm talking about taking a nigga song and just doing it over.
No, I thought you was just saying remix.
Oh, you talking about
feature on a remix? Okay, okay. Well then, X what I said on features on a remix because I didn't hear what you said correctly. Yeah. All right, my bad. Yeah. I started a whole thing off not listening.
She
wasn't even listening right.
We did it right now. Yes, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
I count four.
This is Vince. We'll tell y'all about that later. Jazze Pha has been great tonight. Everything has been magical, man. I really appreciate you coming, bro.
I love you, man.
I love you too, brother. Now it's time to pick your creative curse word.
Oh, my. Uh-oh. I knew it's about to get weird.
It's not. It's going to be amazing. So what this is, so this book, as you can see, has two sides. You're going to randomly flip one side. You're going to randomly flip the other side. And that will be your creative curse word of the week.
Oh, Jesus.
Rocket. You just random, just any page on both sides.
It just
flip whatever you. It. Yep, you got it. Boom. And then. What's the second part? What's the second part? You got to flip the other side.
Oh, both of them?
Randomly. Mm-hmm. This makes up your curse word.
Whore jacket.
What is it?
It's whore jacket.
Whore jacket. You have on a whore jacket.
I wear that.
Jazze Pha's creative curse word of the week is
whore jacket.
Use it in the sentence.
Oh, you nigga, you walk in here with that shit so tight, look like you got on your whore jacket. I was out gardening in my yard and got stung by a whore jacket.
I like it.
That's what it is. Holy shit.
I like it.
Oh, my God.
Stung by a whore jacket.
Hey, listen. Jacket. Listen, I was going to jack my dick, but I decided to let a whore jacket.
But I let a whore jacket.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm your boy T-Pain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am Vanessa Fraction, a.k.a. Action Fraction, the main attraction, your partner's distraction.
And I am just a visitor who's way more exquisiter. Jazzy Frenzel Burgundy, Obama Luther King Jr. Jackson, fire the first.
Yes, sir. Your boy Javon DeJuan is in the building. I stay in the building. TV, family, music, we ain't never stopping.
That's what I'm talking about, ladies. I really appreciate you guys checking out the T-Pain's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
And it ain't gonna suck itself.
The whore jacket's gonna do it. Everybody get to
the whore jackets have spoken.
T-Pain
has a whore jacket on sale. www.whorejacket.com.
Get the fuck out of here, guys. Suck a butt. We'll see you next week. You pieces of shit.
I was gonna jack my kid.
It ain't gonna jack itself.